Good morning, Oak Barrel members and friends. Got a tip here from the Oak Barrel crew, which is all about the maturing or finishing of whiskey. It can be a fairly confusing set of terms for most people, so I'll briefly explain the actual process so people understand. So with most whiskies, they would mature the whiskey in one particular cask for a period of time, let's say approximately 10 years. And often that whiskey will be bottled as is. However, there is the other option that they can take it out of that particular barrel and put it into a new barrel with a particular style of container. So, for instance, you go from a bourbon barrel into a sherry cask barrel, and you'll store that new whiskey in that second barrel for a short period of time. And the idea being to extract as much flavour in a short period of time as possible, but also allowing that barrel to be reused for further whiskies. This process was actually pioneered by Glenmorangie in the late 90s, and it was examples like this one here, the Nectar d'Or, which is finished in Sauterne cask, which is a French sweet wine, that really sort of opened up that process to a number of the other distilleries. So I've got another example here, which is the Glendronic, and this one has been matured for its entire life in Spanish sherry casks. And you can see that it's quite a deep colour, just putting it up to the light. And when you actually taste the whiskey itself, there's some really big fruitcake, sherry-like aromas and flavours there. And you can see that the whiskey itself really shows that it has been matured for its entire life in that sort of cask. And I've got another little oddity here, which is actually a long row whiskey, which has been finished in Gaia Barolo casks. And this is really interesting because it was actually only spent a year and a half in these Gaia Barolo casks. But when you smell and taste the whiskey, it has this really intense cured meat and smoked fish character to it. And what this can show us or demonstrate is that had they actually left the whiskey in that barrel for too long, you would have got to start to get some really hard tannic flavours in there, and it would have been overblown and unbalanced. So guys, I hope that all made a lot of sense to you. I will just let you know that we will also be doing some masterclasses on the lead up to the Whiskey Fair, guys. So if you are interested in doing some classes, please jump online. And that's it for the crew. Thanking you.